I'm assuming this red carpet's for me. Yeah, they put this here for me. Well, guys, it's another farm show time. We're at the Commodity Classic down in Orlando, Florida. It's awesome. This is quite a change from Montana. It was negative 20 when we left. This is pretty nice. It's about 80 degrees out, but this is a little different. Got my first experience at the National Farm Machinery Show as far as a large machinery show, but this one's different. This one is more exclusive. You have to pay more to get into it. A lot smaller audience. But the exhibitors are there, they have more products there. Like the National Farm Machinery Show is roughly 300 to 400,000 people go through the facility around that time. Here they're talking only 8,000 people. Let's get inside, let's take a look and see what's going on in there. All right guys, here's the entrance. I'm all badged up. Let's head in. Now this is a combine I have not seen in person yet. This is the Legacy Series combines, not the flagship. And they came out with this retro look for it. But they got the old IH logo on there. Got the white wheel wells. The way the decals are set up on this thing, it's pretty cool. The cab's got a white top on it. Neat machine. Hey guys, guess who showed up to the Commodity Classic? You probably recognize him.
I don't know what this is though. Where am I?
I'm trying to explain to him this lot that we're in and it isn't quite clicking. He said he's gonna take me to another side of this area and show me some other colors, so
I've
I don't
know. I'm looking for the farming equipment.
Anyways.
I'm just kidding too, for the people that are gonna take me too seriously.
He's actually not. He's been bashing these things the entire time I've been. Oh, cool. Fun. Maybe another year, we'll do this again. Case Project 500 Steiger. This is a row crop track here. Nice and small, not something we'd use in our country, but still pretty cool. But I want to climb up the cab and take a look and see what this looks like in here. Oh, wow. You know, they got music playing out there and a lot of people and traffic, but it is actually very quiet in here. Now the next step would be, what's this thing sound like when it's running? But obviously, I'm not going to start it, so. My guess is eventually here, they're gonna probably transition some of this into that new AFS Connect Magnum style. So this will probably have a lot more color and design to it, but a lot of air vents on that. Wow, if you need air, you're gonna get it. You guys see that? Now we're talking. This here would be a huge upgrade to our farm. I think you can get up towards of a 950 bushel cart on the back of this thing. I think they offer 450 to 950. We don't have anything like this on our farm, and I'd be really curious to see how this would run. So maybe we could make this happen, right? Now guys, this here is just a display model. Obviously they can't fit the whole 60 foot drill in this building without taking up a lot of real estate, which is expensive. So they took a piece of it here, the main frame, just to show you the different assemblies of the discs and the openers and everything on here, just to give guys an idea of the latest changes that they've made to this unit. We have never ran a disc drill besides an old conventional set of drills that had discs on it. We have never ran an air disc drill, precision drill on our farm before. And with our type of soil, I'm really curious if this could really be a big improvement to what we're doing. So I'm sure the answer is yes. Here's our dilemma though. I don't know if our buds can run the hydraulics of that drill. We might need one of these too. Ah, just throw it in. So guys, the rumors are true. 747 Big Bud is gonna get a new set of tires, and Titan here is gonna take care of that for them. And I believe what I'm told is it's gonna be an LSW tire like this. This is a 1250, and they make a 1400, so it's hard to say which one's gonna go on it, but they'll dual it, so yeah, that's pretty awesome. Basically, this tire right here, let me turn this way. See how wide that thing is? That's the 1250, the 1400's quite a bit wider than that. So, looking forward to that. I just talked to the guys, it sounds like things are gonna go down. So stay tuned for that. I see one thing different here too is there's a lot of representatives for each exhibit that's talking to customers and that are look like they're free or open to. So if you want more one-on-one time with each booth, with each company that you would like to talk to, I think you would get it here for sure. The National Farm Machinery Show is a little crazy, and you might have to stand in line and talk to someone, or they might be rushed to try to get you through and talk to the next guy. But here, I think if you've got a serious question about a product or an issue, I think it'd get taken care of. So here at the mini stage, basically each booth has a chance, or at least the ones that sign up, to give a presentation in front of crowds that would like to hear more about it. And then at the end of it, they tell you where they're at and where they're located. So if you like what you hear, you can take off, go to their booth, and talk to them in person. I don't remember the National Farm Machinery Show having that, so that's pretty cool. Now, something for all you farming simulator fans out there, listen up. I ran into some guys here from Corn Warriors, and Mappers Paradise is gonna build the map of the winner of Corn Warriors. And I know where the guy is right now, so let's go talk to him about that.
Right here is our Corn Warrior guy, Seth.
What's up, guys?
The producer, basically the lead man behind Corn Warriors, if you guys have seen the show. And anyways, well, this is kind of a special time for the Marmot Simulator guys because...
Because this year in Corn Warriors, the winner gets their farm mapped to play in the game by Mappers Paradise.
You guys know those guys? They did Welker Farms, and they're good at what they do. Check out Corn Warriors. You can find them on which platforms?
RFD TV, Carbon TV, Amazon Prime, and the top 20 corn producing markets on local broadcasts.
Awesome.
Check out our website, cornwarriorstv.com.
And if you guys look up Mappers Paradise on Facebook, Twitter, Discord, they got a lot of stuff there. They'll give you guys a lowdown too of what's going on. As they're finishing up our map for 19, they're gonna be jumping on the ship to really start making a map for this show. So that's awesome. Good for you guys. Nice talk to you guys. Let's get back to the show. Shout out to Case IH for bringing us out here to this show. They brought us to the Louisville show, the National Farm Machinery Show, and this one is the Commodity Classic 19. These guys have been really good to us. They've made our experience here very enjoyable. We've been able to participate in things that would not normally have happened just because we just are so far away. Thanks, Case. I appreciate it. On behalf of Welker Farms, we just appreciate you guys' support of what we're doing, and we look forward to running our combines this fall, right? Well, guys, this has been pretty cool. This is a good show. I recommend coming to the Commodity Classic 2020. I don't know exactly what state it's going to be in. It does rotate around. Last year was in California. This year is Florida. And so next year, we'll see where it's at. But it's a good show. Worth going to. You guys will enjoy it. And plus, if it's in places like Orlando, you can't beat that. You guys take care. God bless. Tune into the next show. And subscribe.